What's going on, people? It's the Xbox 448, and in today's video, I am tackling that topic of Xbox One exclusives. And you know, ever since Gamescom, even right before Gamescom, with the delay of Crackdown and whatnot, the whole subject of Xbox One exclusives has been a really, really hot topic. Of course, there's people out there who completely hate the Xbox platform that, you know, they come out and they're like, well, where are the games? Where are the games? Where are the exclusives? Xbox has no games. All that good stuff. Now, I do want to say that I am a day one owner of the Xbox One console, and I have been completely happy. You know, the first 3 years of this generation, they have hit me with new IPs like this one right here from Insomniac, Sunset Overdrive, you know, sequels to franchises I already love on Xbox when it comes to Gears, and of course Forza. Forza Horizon is just growing so much as a franchise. And Halo. I mean, you can't talk about Xbox and not talk about Halo. Now, with that being said, you know, people have said that this year is slim when it comes to exclusives. And I'm being nice here because some people have really gone in, you know, and been completely vulgar about this. But Xbox is slim when it comes to exclusives this year. Now, also, since Gamescom, Aaron Greenberg has been put kind of like over the fire pit on certain things that he has said, and I want to get into that as well. But I also want to get into something that Phil Spencer said after E3 to kind of make this all kind of round off and hopefully put some common sense back into gaming news. So here we go. First thing, Aaron Greenberg, big gaming media, has basically taken the words that he stated at Gamescom and really twisted them, in my opinion, and really kind of molded them into whatever they wanted him to say. And here we go. This is what he said. Basically, when it comes to Xbox, he said that people, you know, pick Xbox because they have the biggest franchises, the biggest exclusives. Now, what big gaming media doesn't really say is right after he says that, right after the words, right after he says biggest exclusives, biggest franchises, he says Halo, Gears, and Forza. Now, these three franchises right there are flagship franchises for the Xbox platform. And yes, they are big franchises, all right? He can say biggest, you know, it is a perspective. He's also, you know, the head of marketing. So he is gonna upsell the biggest flagship franchises for Xbox. Now, if you look in terms of context, Halo 5 in the first 3 months sold over 5 million copies. That's kind of big to me, guys. I don't know. What do you think? But, you know, Halo, Gears, and Forza, these are the three franchises. When you're talking Xbox games, when you're talking Xbox, most of the people out there, those are the first three franchises that you think of. Then after that, he said, I am excited for this holiday season for people to be able to play PUBG only on the Xbox in terms of consoles, all right? Now, this is a loose quotation. It's not what he said, like, word for word. But he said he is excited to have PUBG on the Xbox console, only to be played on console this holiday on Xbox. So, wherever it goes in the future, just know that for this holiday season, you know, this game on PC has just sold over 8 million copies. It is on fire right now. It is flying in the PC space. And of course, he is excited to have that title available on console and only on Xbox this holiday. Makes sense to me, right? Then he states about an exclusive, you know, to Xbox for this holiday, which is Super Lucky's Tale, which is not for everybody. Trust me, I know that, but it is an exclusive, and he would not be doing his job if he didn't talk about it. And then, of course, Cuphead has been talked about for about 3 years now. And there are a lot of people that are excited for that game. It is releasing this year for the holidays. So he put that in there. Then he said going into 2018, he is excited because games are dropping like Sea of Thieves, State of Decay 2, Crackdown 3, All right, that's within the first part, like early 2018 in through the spring. These are titles that are coming out on the Xbox platform. So he basically said that, you know, from here on out, we are hitting our gamers with exclusives. And that makes sense. That makes sense to me. Whether or not you like Super Lucky's Tale is up to you. Me, pretty much, I think it's really very, very kiddish. Might not be for me. And it's funny that I'm saying that while you're watching this Minecraft gameplay. But it really seems like a simplified like platformer. But it looks gorgeous. And there are people who are going to pick it up. And he wouldn't be doing his job if he didn't talk about it. Because it's exclusive to Xbox. But all in all, what I think he's trying to state here is that era of Xbox really being holiday heavy and majority of their games coming out on the holiday, I believe he's trying to say that era is over, that there are going to be exclusives kind of like sprinkled in throughout the year instead of just focusing on one part of the year. And that's a good thing. That's something that a lot of people have asked for, even people who don't own a fucking Xbox, right? Who will probably never own an Xbox. That was one of their things to come back about. It's like, oh yeah, well, you know, they only rehash Halo, Gears, and Forza, and they only drop games at one point in time in the year, which is the holidays. And you know, Aaron Greenberg, Phil Spencer, Mikey Barr, they're changing these things. So I looked at it as a you know, kind of like a really good interview. I like what Aaron Greenberg said. I know a lot of people kind of hated on it, especially the big gaming media, but it made sense to me. So as usual, guys, I want you guys to hit up the comment section. I want to hear what you think about what Aaron Greenberg said. And do I make sense here? Does it make sense to you as well? Once you put it in that perspective, that there are games coming out this year, it might not be the amount that you want, it might not be the titles that you want, but Forza Motorsport 7, Cuphead, Super Lucky's Tale, PUBG into game preview. These are games that are coming out for the holidays. And then into next year, look at these titles. Sea of Thieves by Rare, State of Decay 2, which is a title that people want on the platform, especially people that own an Xbox, right? Crackdown 3, which should have been out this holiday, but hopefully there are no more delays. If there's another delay, I am going to go in hard on, you know, that franchise and what Xbox is doing with that franchise. But it's slated for spring 2018. And then it is the same year that a new Forza Horizon is slated to come out as well. And Halo 6. There is a good possibility Halo 6 will be 2018 as well. I have gone on record in stating that Halo 6 needs to come out in 2018. Now, 343, man, they got to get it right all the way around. They have to have that great single player. They have to have that awesome multiplayer. I feel like the Halo 5 multiplayer, in my opinion, perfection. It is the closest to perfection that 343 has come to a multiplayer. Absolutely loved it. Single player, the story, the campaign, I feel like Halo 4, they did really well, and Halo 5, not so much. So they got to put everything together, and I feel like it needs to come out in 2018. So there's a possibility for that game to come out in 2018. Do you see what I'm saying, guys? There's a future in the Xbox platform, and everybody, especially people that don't even like the Xbox, is talking about doom and gloom right now. It just doesn't make sense to me, guys. I don't know. Yo, hit up the comment section. Let me know what you think, guys. Do you see what I'm saying in the future of Xbox One exclusives? I mean, not only that, but Phil Spencer stated that is one of the three things he wanted to do when he became head of the Xbox division. The first two was taking care of the hardware situation, which he did with last year's Xbox One S and this year's Xbox One X. And the second thing he wanted to do was make sure that you were able to get the Xbox app on multiple platforms such as iOS, Android, and whatnot. And he has done that as well. That's another reason why I don't see the doom and gloom, is because when he had his three things to do, the first two checkmarked beautifully. Hardware, done. Xbox Live, multiple platforms, done. And now it's about the exclusives, and I feel there are many coming down the road. But as usual, guys, you know, If you like the topics, you like the gameplay, definitely hit that thumbs up button for me. Definitely hit up the comment section. I want to know what you guys think about this. But as always, this is the X-Spot 448. And I am definitely signing off.